Hi guys, and welcome to a new vlog. Today, we'll have a look at the 147 Alfa Romeo GTA. So, as you can see from the type of the video, we are from the office, let's call it office, because I am positive to COVID, no problems with my health in reality, but I need to stay home. So I've decided to look at the Alfa Romeo 147 GTA because I want to buy one. I don't know how I will do it, but first of all I looked at some, I know quite well the model. I really like it. I think that the motor is amazing. If you look also on YouTube, you have for sure already a lot of content. So a lot of people already tried it in Italian, in English, Top Gear, Car Throttle. So all the biggest ones already tried this GTA. So pros and cons, we can know them very, very easily, I would say. So it's easy to go and find a good model. So first of all, I had a look at all the videos in YouTube, as you've just seen, and some colors and interiors. So you can have the interiors in fabric, as you can see from here, and in leather. So what I found is that there are quite a lot of Rosso Alfa cars, black, nero metallico, and the best one in my opinion is the Bianco Nuvola, that is a pearl white. Obviously pearl white with black Monte Carlo leather interiors would be really great, but I didn't find any. So going back to here, to Wikipedia, obviously we can use it because it's very interesting. We can see that the 147 GTA was launched in 2002 and it has a 3.2 liter engine V6 named Busso with 250 brake horsepower. So it's really, really powerful, and it reaches 246 kilometers per hour. The very interesting thing, in my opinion, is that you can have it in a manual 6-speed transmission or with what they call the cell speed automated manual system. The good thing is that it's not edition, but as you can see from here, they made only 5,029 manual GTAs and 1,004 cell speeds. So you really, really don't find a lot of them around, and future it will go up also in the value. The very interesting thing for who wants to maybe track the car is this Auto Delta has also made a Rotrex supercharged version producing 400 brake horsepower. You can imagine that obviously being a 3.2 liter engine, we can modify it quite heavily, obviously. So it's a front transmission, V6, 3.2 liters, petrol, and we can do really good things. 300 Newton meters of torque, as you can see from here, and 0 to 100 kilometers per hour or 0 to 62 miles per hour, 6.3 seconds. My preferred website to search for cars is Autoscout24, and it's practically in all Europe. You can see I have some like Volkswagen R32, Audi TT, some things. So we go to the Alfa Romeo 147 GTA, obviously. Let's put them let's see if I can put it in English so that everybody can understand. Oh, where's English? So here it is in English. I go through the price ascending, obviously. So we start from this, that is not a GTA, this is a GTA. Quite a lot of kilometers, probably some problem because this price is very, very low. We've got this 9,900, but it's heavily modified. So in Italy, it's not really well seen. And it's in Nuremberg, Germany again. This is quite a rare color. I think it should be the Grigio Sterling or Azzurro Gabbiano. I never understood what is the difference. Maybe later we can go and see it. And then there are quite a lot in Holland. So we found this one with quite a lot of kilometers. Then we go to this red one in Germany again, Spain, but quite a lot with a lot of kilometers. What did I do? I phoned to this one with actually quite a lot of kilometers, but the car is absolutely original and I needed original. And then I called also this guy, FDT Sports Cars, and who knows where I will buy it, here or here, I don't know. They're both in Holland. So also easy to send somebody to have a look. 13,500 also for this. 86,000 kilometers only in Germany, so very, very interesting. If we go inside this one, that is the one I liked most, you can see that it is a 2006 car with 87,000 kilometers. It's completely original, except for the rims that have been colored again. But in any case, xenon lights and leather interiors. So it's full optional, I would say. Except for the radio, that it doesn't have the navigation system, but personally I don't care a lot about that. And it's a manual transmission, so we said around 5,000 cars produced. Very interesting is also the Bose sound system. So this, okay, and going back, let's see why probably this, the first one, costs so less. So it's a 3.2 liter GTA, correct, 177 kilometers. It has been a bit modified. Leather interiors, navigation system, manual gearbox, sorry. So everything actually seems good. I should translate the description here. In any case, in Italy, I need the car to be completely original. So I need to go on an original car, but this actually, except for the kilometers, it seems a very good occasion. Here I found that it was heavily modified, I had already seen it, and you can see also the back part, the side skirts, they have been all modified. So if we do like this, you can see it, all this part has been modified. But again, if you needed to use it all, every evening, every day, as you like, it's a fantastic car, absolutely. In my case, I need it with less kilometers as possible, with everything original. So I think that going down, the first one that we find with a few kilometers is this one, and everything is original. Going up, let's see if there is something interesting. Going, well, obviously we go up with price. We have this that is mint condition practically, because it's a 14,500 kilometers in Germany. This is 80,000 kilometers. You will never sell it for this price. But this just to tell you that the prices are going up. So obviously cars need to be with very low mileage and obviously mint condition, because if I go, let's say, to this one, let's see. Xenon lights, seems everything original. Ooh. Interiors are not leather, but okay, we can cope with that. But navigation system, I don't see the Bose sound system, but okay, he shows he's got all the keys and stuff of the car, so okay, maybe, you know, everything is it's already registered to the RIAR. So this is very important in Italy, because they register the car if it's completely original, and you can get a very big discount on the tax, road tax and insurance. Obviously, I've looked also at other cars, like the Ford Focus RS, as we see in this Top Gear car review. I've looked also at the R32, here it is. Volkswagen Golf R32. Also the 5 series is very nice in my opinion, with the 3.2 liter, is very interesting. But I think that the best is absolutely this car. And as Jeremy Clarkson says in a drag race, what happens by the free? So this is enough for me. Going back to the car I would like to buy. So this one, or let's see if it charges this one. I would ask you, what do you think about it? Because the two cars are practically the same. As you can see, leather interiors also here, manual transmission, navigation system, Bose sound system. So the difference of price is not so big. The difference in kilometers is quite a lot. They're both in Holland. I would not move from here. So it's the first time I buy a car without going to look at it. So I don't know if some users that are watching this video want to give me some suggestion, something to check. If you already had it, what do you think about it? What I should change as soon as I get it? I'm open for comments. So leaving you on the images of the fantastic 147 GTA. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you enjoyed it, again, share it with your friends. More than welcome. And subscribe to my channel and mash on the like button. Thank you very much for watching. And see you on the next video, probably, where I will buy this Alfa Romeo GTR. What do you think about it?